Now we'll start a new project using the plugin template. Let's call this plugin Controller Monitor. The first thing that we want to edit is the plugin definition. This class is the starting point for a plugin integration that defines the plugins that we want to include. Most importantly, for our case, the item nodes are specified here. Let's go to the init method, where the item nodes are configured. As we can see, the template has added an item node and named it according to our template. Let's name these items Controller and Controllers. The item's allowed property is set to many in this case, which allows an administrator to add more than one item. Next, we go to the identification properties and expand that region. There, we may want to edit the name of the plugin and potentially other fields like manufacturer and version. Let's change the name to Controller Monitoring. This is the top-level name in the tree hierarchy of the site navigation in the management client. Let's save the project and build it to verify the changes. We create a new directory for our plugin under the MIP Plugins directory. Then, we stop the event server and close any client applications that may be open. After that, we copy the DLL and plugin.dev files from the build directory to the directory we just created. Now we'll start the event server and log in with the management client. As we can see under the MIP plugins, the parent item for all the items is Controller Monitoring, under which we have the controllers. Let's add an item to our new plugin and then return to coding. As we can see, the only property a controller has is the name, which is provided by the MIP plugin template. We'll continue by creating some custom properties for our items. The properties can be added in the user control. We add two new elements, a text box for an IP address, and a checkbox to indicate whether an item is enabled. The values of these two elements will be saved as item properties. This is how we can have our own custom data saved in the configuration. Before we leave the graphical elements, we need to make sure that the onUserChange event is triggered if the values in the text box or checkbox change. This will inform the system that there are unsaved changes and set the Save icon to active. Let's continue by looking at the code for the user control. We'll paste the code that you would be writing. First, we create getter and setter methods to read and write the properties. This step is not necessary, but simplifies the reading and writing operations. In the fillContent method, we are getting the values for the user control from the configuration. Here, we first check for the existence of a property before setting a value in the user control. This is a good practice that helps prevent errors. The checkbox state is determined by the property value of the enabled key. Update item will save the information that has been entered in the user control. Notice that the properties are always strings. Clear content should set the values of each field to blank or whatever the default state is. Now we can build the project and test it. The procedure is the same. First, close the client applications and the event server. Then copy the updated DLL to the plugin directory. Note that the plugin.def doesn't need to be copied anymore. Then start the event server and open the management client. Let's navigate to the MIP plugin section in the site navigation. If we look at the item we already created before adding the new properties, we can see that new properties exist but have no value. Let's update it to make sure it works by adding an IP address and clicking Save. In this case, we use the local host address. This will be used for testing later. Let's add one more item. If we clear the Enabled checkbox and save, we'll see the red X indicating a disabled item. This is a built-in feature in the MIP that you can see in many other instances where items can be disabled, such as the rule system and alarm definitions. Clicking back to the item we saved earlier confirms that the new properties are saved in the configuration. Well done.